Stephanie Necuze, correspondent for Florida Grand Opera. Follow me backstage as we talk to members of the cast of FGO's newest production, Roméo and Juliette. So this production of Roméo and Juliette is the classic story that we all know and love, but you bring in some modern elements with the use of light projections. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Well, we want to heighten the emotion as much as possible. So when Roméo and Juliette first meet and they have that first spark of love, we use fire to be the tableau behind them that sparkles and crackles with that potential of love. In Act Two, when we see that they're almost overwhelmed with love, the idea of water comes in as if they're almost drowning in the sea of love that they've created, and so on and so forth through the production.
So you've sung the role of Roméo in concerts before, but I understand that this is your first time doing it in an opera production. How was it?
Wow, it was great. I just came out of the stage and it was amazing because, like you said, it's my first one on stage and the end was so intense. I felt that it was the end of my life. It was very strange. And I was crying with Maria as Juliet too, and already it's just 2 minutes done and I am still in the sky.
Still emotional.
Yeah, exactly.
It's also your first time fighting on stage with a sword. How was that experience for you?
That was amazing too. I felt like if I was in a Star Wars movie or something like that. The stunt team was very good to explain how to do, to look very real. And we did a lot of training before and kind of video, and it was very funny. It was like come back to a teenager, like a child.
Why should people come see Roméo and Juliette?
Because it's great. And because we are giving everything on stage. Really, Mia, we try to every night to sing with our heart, and so we do the best that we can. So I hope that the audience will enjoy.